Welcome back to Ferocious Education. This is Ed. Today we're looking into two things: financials and where they can actually improve their financials, latest news, institutional buyers, and then the bubble of technical analysis. So let's jump right into this one. So Palantir. So this one here, I've gone through them before. They have different solutions from AI to machine learning to auto racing, COVID responses, defenses, the list goes on. They're a technology company with data analytics power and anything you can think of freely. And I want to go through a couple of things in terms of the financials, but we'll do that in a little bit. We need to just give a quick update on the latest news. And just keep in mind before moving on towards the latest news, on April 14th, they do have at 11 a.m. a demo that they're going to go show for some of their products, such as Foundry, Gotham, etc. will probably be showcased on there. Currently, they have introduction, demo life science, and demo industries. So I'm not exactly sure what they're going to be showing, because, well, it's a demo, it's not out yet, but it should be exciting there for stakeholders. Nonetheless, we're going to move on towards the latest news here, and some of the latest news, and coming in from the most important to, I guess, the older news, not the least important, of course. But starting off, we do have some of the latest news that it goes on towards Palantir selected by the National Nuclear Security Administration for a five-year contract going almost $100 million. It's $89.9 million contract for safer projects. So this pans in for 5 years. It's an important direction because nuclear energy has always been an issue in terms of mitigating and also making sure that safety programs are in place. So Palantir there, that might actually bring other contracts related to nuclear energy. And then we're going to move on as well to one of the most important ones that a lot of people don't seem to recognize is Ferocious and their perspective by reaching carbon dioxide neutral or CO2 neutral levels. So that is also something important that will bring other customers here. So just keep that in mind. But now we're going to move on towards their financials. And if you would like to see more materials like this, make sure to hit that subscribe button and leave notifications on. And in terms of the revenue itself, we're looking into two things. Their 2020 quarter, 3 months, or December 31st, fourth quarter, and also the year end. So from here, we see year over year revenue between quarter four 2020 and 2019 hasn't been much different, other than perhaps around 80 million in terms of revenue. In terms of cost revenue, this has decreased, so that's actually quite amazing, because you're having, in terms of the gross profits, having almost gone double. Even though your revenue have always only increased around 50%, your margins on gross profit has increased more than 50% because your cost of revenue has decreased. In terms of marketing and sales and marketing, in research and development and general administration, you see an increase respectively from 2019 year over year, and this gets you to total operating expenses to be 400 million compared to 300 million. And so your total loss of operations, and this is what I was referring to, not much difference seen here, is that the loss of operations on 2020 quarter four is actually more than quarter three. Now there's only a difference of 9 million out of 156 million and 147 million respectively. Nonetheless, what we see here is other income expenses net. This here is positive. This is from value of warrants. But your net loss at the end of the day for quarter four 2020 compared to quarter four 2019 is just marginally lower. So you're talking about 10 million out of 150, 160 million. Now the net loss per share, it's because they have more shares now, it's of course going to show better. But perhaps let's say the 2020 year end. Now keep in mind there was some costs related towards IPOing, but the revenues have increased from 742 million to somewhere around 1.1 million. Meanwhile, their cost of revenues has increased there, giving the gross profits to still be greater than 2019, around 740 million compared to 500 million. Now the sales and marketing, that has skyrocketed. Research and development went almost double. General administrative costs went further on from double. And so your total operating expenses is almost double. And what that has caused is that the loss from operations is more than double from 2019. Again, keep in mind that this is an IPO year. So some of that general administrative costs and maybe sales and marketing will be directed towards the IPO. And scrolling down just a little, in terms of the net loss, you're looking at 1.1 billion compared to 580 million 2020 to 2019, again, an IPO year. And so you get to see that the major parts of their balance sheet is relating towards general and administrative. And if they were to cut that a little, perhaps increase our revenue while still decreasing cost of revenue, very similar to what they've done in quarter four 2020 year over year to quarter four 2019, then you can start seeing some positive returns there. So what about SEC filing? In SEC filing, you see that they have $400 million credit existing agreement there, up from 200 million before. Well, that's an increase of 200 million up from around 100 million as well. So their total currently is around $400 million in total revolving credit commitment. There's multiple things to it, but generally it is around $400 million. Now, institutional buyers here, what we are seeing is that institutions are still loving this one, picking more and more as we go, and we're going to move on now towards technical analysis. So from a technical analysis standpoint, on the one-day perspective, here's where things get really interesting. The 10 SMA is above 30 EMA, and this is the trading action zone where positive reversals are likely, and that band is between 2465 and 2281, so you can start expecting bullish reversals up to 2465. In terms of volume per sonar, it's sitting still a bit closer towards the overbought, but not there yet, so that's a good thing. MACD has crossed the positive first time in a bit, and that's an indication for a positive reversal. Really bullish there, and momentum is creeping up towards a zero. It's not yet, it's negative 177. Now, the moving average band here, we're expecting this one to trade between 2635 on the top, 2396 in the middle, and 2156 in the bottom. So these are levels of resistances, support, etc. Now we're going to move on towards stochastic fast and stochastic slow. And what we're seeing here is they're both indicating that this might actually be a good time to buy towards the next resistance. And the next resistance here, we're able to see it on the Fibonacci retracements and then following just normal charting. So we're going to go with 890 towards the bottom. And we're seeing that the very next support here is 2272. The one below it is 1744. Resistances are 2698, 3124, 3731, and 4505. Current price line action shows a very strong support at the 2338. Below there, 2238. Below there, you're looking at 2215. And below there, 1992. You're looking down towards 1676, 1442, and 1090. Significant resistances, you're looking at 2414, and then you're seeing 2513, 2748, 2912, 3082, 3363, 3603, and then diving up to 3808 and almost $40. Comes to the question to Ed, what do you think about this one? There's definitely some concern towards their balance sheet. Nonetheless, I do think that above that level of around 2120 level, it has a lot of a strong chance, or it has a lot of potential that it can easily go towards the $28-$27 back in there. So that's if that's the range you're looking for in terms of a long-term investment. It looks like institutions are betting strongly on it. There's a lot of interest in this company, has a lot of future ahead of it. Again, it's a lot of it is intrinsic value, and I do see that they will be able to fix their financials. It might take a couple of years or so, but a lot of companies out there, for instance, Tesla wasn't profitable for the longest time. As long as you have a good vision, a good model, you might actually go on and see more revenue, more strength, more support over there. What do you think about the sticker? Make sure to mention down in the comments below. Share, subscribe, and like. Have a wonderful day.